Laser Cooling ist pretty cool. Laser Cooling is an amazing phenomenon. Lasers are, of course, a directed form of energy. If you hold your hand in a laser beam, you feel the heat. Because the light, the photons, which is energy, are absorbed by your skin, are converted into random motion, and we feel that as heat. Well, with some of the lasers we have in our labs, you can even burn your flesh. So this is how lasers heat. But if you apply laser radiation to atoms, there's one important difference. The atoms cannot keep the light. When atoms have been excited to a more energetically higher state, they have to re-emit the photon. So a photon which is absorbed with 100% probability is re-emitted. So therefore the energy which the atoms absorb is emitted again as fluorescence. And now on a much more subtle scale, when we use the right laser light with the right frequency, we can arrange for situations where the emitted light is slightly more energetic than the absorbed light. And it's quite fascinating how that comes about. So what happens is we need a frequency shift of the light, but in its simplest form, this is just provided by the well-known Doppler effect, which makes the frequency of light depend, if a moving object emits light, the frequency depends on the direction of emission, and that is sufficient to make lasers cool. I try to be reasonable and conservative. I knew about Bose-Einstein condensation, but it was also clear that with laser cooling, we were missing a factor of million in density, or in phase-space density, which is a more technical term. So we were a factor of a million away from Bose-Einstein condensation. And I felt it was almost frivolous to talk about it. We are now going for Bose-Einstein condensation. So for myself and for my lab, we declared the goal. We want to combine laser cooling with evaporative cooling, and we want to get at least a little bit colder and a little bit denser than anybody before us.